So now we're up to the final step of the design thinking process, the launch. This is where all of your hard work gets into the audience's hands. It's the handover to the client, where you present your work and provide them with all the files they need. It's making sure your files are named correctly so they're easily found. And for your team, it's also a period of reflection where you can analyse the performance, learn from any mistakes along the way, and fine-tune the process for next time.
One area that's becoming increasingly popular is the folder system within Canva. Here, you can organise your documents, name them easily, and share them with others. Let's take a look. From the homepage side panel, click Your Projects. Click the Folders tab. You can add a folder here or hover your mouse over an existing folder you want to manage. Click the three-dot icon that appears. Available functions will depend on the folder's ownership and edit access given to you. Typically, you'll be able to rename, move, share, and delete folders from here. If it's a folder you're going to be regularly returning to, you can star it, and it will appear here for easy access. Once you are in the folder, you can add designs to the folder by choosing Add Design and Choose Design. You can also upload from your computer, add additional folders, and import from Google Drive. One great feature you can use in folders is the Present Folder. This will create a presentation playlist from everything in this folder. This is perfect for when you have multiple documents or presentations from different individuals or teams. Simply get them to add their designs to the folder. Click the three-dot icon from the upper corner of the page. Select Present Folder. A playlist of your folder will appear. Drag presentations up or down in the list to set the order in which they will appear. Click Present Items to start presenting. The best thing is, last-minute changes can still be made to designs added to playlists. The most up-to-date versions will be shown. So while one team is presenting, the next team can be updating and improving at the same time.
This is a great tool to use to finish off the design thinking workshop. Get the teams to quickly pull together all their work from the session into a presentation. Throw it into a group folder and then present it all from the one machine. There's no need to swap or download files or connect different laptops to the provided screens. It's just a seamless transition from one presentation to the next. And, you know, the main point of this stage in the design thinking workshop is giving the teams a chance to show what they've come up with and talk about how they've learnt or what they've learnt through the five previous steps. They've got to the end and they're probably likely tired, and now's a chance for them to appreciate what they've learnt and observed. For the facilitators, this stage means they need to collect all the documents and concepts that have been shown. It's going to be their job to collate the many different ideas into a concise and clear outcome. This stage is also a chance for the participants to give their feedback to the facilitators about how they found the workshop. What could be improved and where do they find barriers? This kind of information is gold for a business that wants to incorporate design thinking into everything they do. So at this stage, maybe give the teams a final survey to complete while everything is still fresh in their minds. And the final thing to do is celebrate. You've made it through the whole design thinking process. It's intense, but hopefully you've gathered some insights that you just couldn't have gotten any other way. The team's going to feel more bonded, and they're going to have ownership of the concepts and also the action items. But we're not quite finished yet. There's one more chapter in this series to help you understand how to make the design thinking process your own and adapt it to your particular needs. In fact, there's many different versions of the process that we use right here in Canva. Join me in our next video to learn how to modify and evolve the steps to fit your goals.